And I've been waiting, running to the Lord. I'm coming home cause he been patient. I've been hella faithful to Satan. Mind changing, I'm just trying to get it right before he replace me. You know sin is contagious, yeah. I'm looking forward but mentally stumbling morally. My mind telling me the world glitter and it's more to see. I'm running from myself, going double time mentally. Sometimes I shock myself, I ain't know that thing exists in me. How to me against the enemy. War time and I ain't looking for a friend in me, yeah. Lord, shine some rays on me, I ain't a gangster, but sometimes I gotta tap into that energy. World shakers, no Creflo, but world changes. Still aging, pray when he find me, I'm found faithful. World shakers, no Creflo, but world changes. Still aging, pray when he find me, I'm found faithful.
I've been going double, yeah. I've been going double time. I've been going double, yeah. I've been going double time. I've been going double, yeah. I've been going double time. I've been going double, yeah. I've been going double time.
Yeah, man. Ever since I found out the truth about my nationality, I've been going hard on the daily, spiritually. All these curses put on a nation, slavery. Crazy the way that I'm pacing, but I put my faith in Most High. I know who I am now, I know that I'm chosen, and I don't plan on going
I've been
back.
Going double, yeah. I've been going
double time.
I've been going double, yeah. I've been going double time. I've been going double, yeah. I've been going double time. Double time.
Yeah. Seek him 10,000 times. I'm in overdrive. The workload don't move.
move slow. My hat's off to true folks. I salute those that follow the JUCO. No days off, bringing the light to the people like Akon. Our faith strong like King Kong. We'll move in a moment. And it's 0 to 100 from night to the morning till we get it how we want it. Yeah.
Round and around and around we go. Same old thing, still ain't had enough. Round and around and around we go again.
Learned the truth and took off like a rocket. Got me going double time like I'm rocking two watches. It feels good to be a prophet surrounded by prophets. And I refuse to be that dog that returned to his vomit. Father, I'm working to come back to you. Studying the word in the scripts like I'm a character. Keeping these commandments and that's building up my character. Driving out these demons, now no more dodging them challenges. I done away with all those spirits I was entertaining. Hoping and praying that you listen to my supplication. Constantly changing to the God that you created. Ain't feeling suicidal, but I'm trying to die daily. Cause I know the mission and I know what's waiting in the ending. The kingdom's coming, we getting closer, I can feel it. Gotta stay diligent, I'm steady playing my position. Lord knows that I don't wanna miss it. So I've been going
double, yeah. I've been going double time.
Tell me where the love goes. Where the love? Tell me where the love goes. Tell me what it is, what it is, what it was though. You looking puzzled. Cutting them all off, you can get severed. Tell me now, where did the love go? Where did the love go?
Cutting them off, they dead twice. Something I never get, like his headlights. Is you frontin' like headlights, like these niggas? They read scriptures, then they pass them off like flea flickers. At minimum, keep it 3 digits. It broke my heart seeing Serena spin the father face. The race you date gave him nothing but hate. But somehow you found a mate where it's not the case. We'll watch and wait, cause God is great. I've been watching from outer space, ain't it separate?
This is the message. Cutting them all off, tell me now, where did the love go? Where did the love go?
Correction brings perfection, so every lesson I'm perfecting. Even though they laugh at my face, behind my back, they respect it. Got a Midas touch when love is cost. I know your sins when your soul is lost. Let's be honest, for the Father we pay homage, what's your life worth? In every city, in every town, he's choosing us first. Cannot compare me to a nigga, we let that all burn. From the highways to the hedges, we be telling them be separate, be separate.
This is the message. Cutting them all off, tell me now, where did the love go? Where did the love go? This is the message. Cutting them all off, tell me now, where did the love go? Where did the love go?
live?
Check, check. Yeah, we live. We live. All praises.
Okay, there we go. All right, Shalom, Israel, Most High, Christ, bless. Hey, first and foremost, I want to say happy Sabbath to everybody. The title of today's lesson, you see the thumbnail, The Death of Christianity. Let me repeat, The Death of Christianity. I want to open up with Isaiah chapter 30 and verse 20. Isaiah 30, verse 20.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 30 and verse 10, which say to the seers, see not, and to the prophets, Isaiah 30 and verse 20. And though the Lord give you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction.
So you see, Israel, we going through a lot of trials right now. Look, I'm counseling brothers, sisters every day. Hey, the Lord giving us the bread of adversity and the water of affliction. Because some of y'all breaking out into tears behind these trials and tribulations you dealing with. Read on.
Yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore, but thine eyes shall see thy teachers.
The scripture say thy eyes shall see thy teachers. Y'all know why we getting a lot of affliction right now, why Israel getting a lot of affliction? Because, we didn't gave Christianity a death blow. Christianity is out the door. You know what I'm saying? And the last leg for Christianity, who's trying to still put up a fight, is probably them Christian apologists. And we've been serving them up. Man, we've been getting them Christian apologists to work. They come on Clubhouse. They've been getting dealt with day in and day out. So Christianity on his last leg. Look, let's read Revelation chapter 12, verse 12. So as we sit up there and constantly lay siege on Christianity, y'all see the spirit of Satan is active within the earth. And I'm talking about when the spirit of Satan comes, you're going to know Satan coming. And I ain't talking about Esau. I'm talking about Satan. Read that real quick. Revelation chapter 12, verse 12.
Revelation chapter 12 and verse 12. Therefore, rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea. For the devil has come down unto you having great wrath.
They say the devil has come down having great wrath. That's why you're dealing with so many trials and tribulations right now. You wonder why, man, like, wow, why I'm going through this? Why I'm dealing with that? The Satan has great wrath right now. Why? Look at all the work we've been putting in. We've been putting in so much work within the last 2 or 3 years, and we didn't cripple Christianity. Read on.
Because he knoweth that he hath but a short time.
Because he know he have but a short time. He know that Christ's kingdom is coming. So now look, I want to get this first video. And I want to start at the 3-minute mark. We're going to jump clean into it. Now, of course, y'all know last week we had our men's conference. And we blitzed the Cherry Hills Projects. You know what I'm saying? Something that ain't never been done before. And y'all got to think, when we do these things, we make impacts throughout the earth. We send shockwaves throughout the earth. And a lot of people get to reevaluate things. They get to looking at, they listen to the things we say. I left the church. They were like, hold on, I wonder why these men left the church. You know what I'm saying? They get to thinking about, wait, why our church ain't doing nothing like this. Matter of fact, they be thinking, they asking questions like, how all these men are able to assemble and come together in unity in the spirit of Christ, and they can't do it. Now look, let's open up with the 3-minute mark on this video.
And so I'm going to start talking about this from a different perspective. Now, I disagree with what they stand for in the premise of this organization. They claim to be the true Hebrews, the 144,000 in the book of Revelation, and that it's only reserved for Black, Latino, Native Americans. It's race idolatry.
Now, look, I want to go and stop him right now.
So,
because, see, sometimes, look, when you hear these Negroes, you just got to go ahead and just stop them in the tracks automatically. First and foremost, he said, we claim that blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans are the 144,000. Now, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the Israelites the Bible speaks of. The Israelites are the 144,000. Let's get there real quick in Revelation chapter 7, verse 4. You gotta watch some of these Negroes that's too smart for their own good. Now, the brother, you know what I'm saying, he made some good points in support of us, but you gotta watch the opposition that comes behind these men when they sit up there. They'll say good things in support of us, but really they in opposition to what we're doing. Read what you got.
Revelation chapter 7 and verse 4. And I heard the number of them which were sealed. And they were sealed 144,000.
Read.
Of all the tribes of the children of Israel.
Listen, of all the tribes of the children of Israel. So listen, my brother. The 144,000 is of all the tribes of the children of Israel. And you can read the rest of Revelation chapter 7 to see that. It tells you it was sealed 12,000 from Judah, 12,000 from Benjamin. What Bible is y'all Christians read? And see, this is why Christianity is dead. This is why Christianity is dying. This is why black men are fleeing the church. Hell, even black women fleeing the church now. They sick and tired of seeing the weak and effeminate men that don't know what the hell they talking about. And then go back, hit that video again, because I noticed he keeps saying the same word. One of them, I forgot the name of their brother, their bishop did the interview with. He keeps saying that racial idolatry stuff. Go back like 5 seconds. Yeah, Jason. Yes, Jason. Jason Whitlock. This racial idolatry stuff.
Couched in the Bible. So it's not biblical. If you read Acts 17:26, where Paul says,
so look,
and he has made from one blood.
Stop right there. God is about race. And the proof in the pudding of that, get Deuteronomy 73 real quick. God is about race. I don't know what Bible y'all read. And we've been approved that God is about race. And see, when people see this, when you watch videos like this, you'll see the work that we done. You'll see the impact we done made. And then somebody take our video, they'll say good things about us, and then they'll sit up there and they'll mix it with all types of other gibberish or stuff that don't make sense. Or they'll try to put their own biblical understanding in it for the people who do want to learn, for them to be swayed off. Read what you got.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 3. Neither shall I make marriages with them.
Now look, I'm going to here for a reason, because I said God is about race. When you read verse 7, the Lord is telling us not to make marriages with these different nations. Read on.
Thy daughter thou shalt not give unto his son.
He said, look, don't give your daughter to his son. Read.
Nor his daughter shalt thou take unto thy son.
And he said, look, don't take your daughter to his son. Israelites should be marrying outside of their race. Our men should be going after the white woman, the Chinese woman. Our sisters should be going after the white man, the Chinese man, the East Indian. We shouldn't be doing it. Read on.
For they will turn away thy son from following me, that they may serve other gods. So will the anger of the Lord be kindled against you and destroy thee suddenly.
Then, as you continue to read on, read verse 6. It's telling you exactly why God is against race mixing. Read.
Verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
The Israelites are holy. God is about race. And he sure don't want them mixing the race. Read on.
The Lord thy God has chosen thee.
And he chosen you. God chosen the Israelites above all nations on the planet. Read on.
To be a special people.
Then you special. God is about race. God said, look, hey, I chose you to be holy. I chose you to be special above all nations. Read on.
To be a special people unto himself.
Unto himself. God chose a race of people unto himself. So what Bible is these Christians reading? And see, look, as y'all continue to talk, we're going to continue to deliver them blows.
Hey, Cap.
The death blows to Christianity.
Hey, Cap. But why they don't say the same thing about Esau claiming that they are the real Hebrews.
Yeah.
They never say anything about race. They okay with that. But when we say it and we prove it, oh, it's racial, what's it called? Racial idolatry. That's some BS, bro. Stockholm syndrome is what they got.
Hey, for real though. Now look, I sent you that thing with Ezra, because I want to go into Ezra's chapter 9 and 1. And I want to read it in a different version. Because, see, I'm going to tell y'all something, too. This what you got, and I don't know if this guy apologizes or not, but this what you got to watch with these so-called super Christians that think they know something. You know what I'm saying? Just like with Acts 17 to 26, and we about to dig into that. Because he been a butcher the hell out of that scripture. So somebody that don't know the Bible, and they watching our video, or they watching this video, because a lot of people use our videos for clickbait or to get views, to sit up there to push their objective. They don't know and got no good understanding of the Bible. And they don't understand the only way to get that good understanding of the Bible is to keep the commandments of God. Listen to me. If they ain't keeping the commandments of God, they don't know the Bible. It's simple as that. Now, put that up there for me. I sent you a screenshot. It say Ezra's prayer about interracial marriage. And we're going to read it in a different version. Because remember, I made the point, and I sat up there and said, God is about race, and he's especially against race mixing. So put that up there, Ezra's prayer about interracial marriage. It was a screenshot. Okay. Now, I sent y'all a whole list of, it's a whole list. I got everything on that list. Y'all have to scroll up it, though. Okay, y'all got it? All right, all praise, all praise. All right, so give it a minute, Israel, give it a minute. So read the bottom of verse 6 again while they're getting it. Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6.
Read.
For thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God.
So the Israelites are holy, read.
The Lord thy God has chosen thee.
And they are chosen. The Lord said they holy, they chosen, read.
To be a special people.
To be a special race of people. A special race of people. God is about race. So where the hell y'all keep getting this racial idolatry thing from? The hell? They done made up some. They done made up a term. And look, this, you got to watch these Negroes like this. Because they'll start to popularize this stuff. Next thing you know, everybody that's in opposition to us, they'll be saying and repeating the same thing. You got that for me yet? Ezra's prayer about interracial marriage. Now, I think this is the New King James Version of the Bible. I think this is the NIV. I forgot which one this was. Where we at? Oklahoma.
They talk about, idolatry. Sir. But the church is full of idolatry.
That's what I'm saying.
They full of idolatry.
Full of idolatry, for real. Everything they do, don't you know, I'm glad you said that, because every holiday they keep is based on idolatry.
Facts.
Every holiday they keep. So here we go. That's on the screen. It say, and I'm going to read it. It say, Ezra's prayer about interracial marriage. Now, I really want to get to straight
full
to
screen.
The point.
Full screen. Hit the green button.
It say, After these things have been done, the leaders came to me and said, the people of Israel, including the priests and the Levites, have not kept themselves separate from the neighboring peoples with their detestable practices like those of the Canaanites, Hittites, Perizzites, Jebusites, Ammonites, Moabites, Egyptians, and Amorites. You know in Deuteronomy chapter 71, these same nations is listed there. Right. And then it say, they have taken some of their daughters as wives for themselves and their sons, and have mingled the holy race with the peoples around them. So even the scholars understand. The translator understand that God is about race. So what in the hell is these people talking about? But hey.
And a lot of these apologetics and so-called Christians like to run to these versions of the Bible.
Yeah.
And try to say, oh, the King James Version is too hard to understand. Here and on, the same different translation that you like to run to, it shows that God is about race.
But you know they pick and choose. Them dudes pick and choose. Even with these damn apologies. Excuse my language. Even with these apologies. They sit up there, they love commentaries. But they pick and choose the commentaries that they want. Because it's a few commentaries. It's a small amount that's in opposition to some of the other commentaries that's out there. They going to find the things that fit their agenda, and they take scripture and twist it. We're going to prove it in a minute with this Acts 17 and 26 about to bring out. Now, go to Ecclesiastes chapter 26, verse 19 real quick. So God is about race, and he don't want you mingling the holy race. He don't want you mixing the holy seed, man. You a holy people. You chosen. It's simple as that. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing wrong with that. Should you say it's unrighteousness with God? God forbid. Read.
The book of Sirach, chapter 26 and verse 19. My son, keep the flower of thine age sound.
Read.
And give not thy strength to strangers.
This is saying the same thing as Deuteronomy 7 and 3. Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 3 and 4. And Ezra chapter 9, 1 through 4. The whole chapter is about interracial marriages. They even set up there and put away the wives in the book of Ezra. And the kids that they was having from them folks. Read on.
When thou hast gotten a fruitful possession through all the field.
The fruitful possession that it's talking about through all the field is talking about that Israelite woman. That's their fruitful possession. Read.
Sow it with thine own seed.
The Lord said, sow it with your own seed. What seed did you eat to my sperm? Right. Put your sperm in your women. Don't put your sperm in Esau. Don't put your sperm in Moab, the Jebusites, the Ferbusites, the Ammonites. Read on.
Trusting in the goodness of thy stock.
It say trusting in the goodness of thy stock. Your race. Read on. It's going to tell you right here that your stock is talking about your race. Read on.
So thy race.
So thy race. So thy race. So what the hell y'all keep talking about? Racial idolatry. So thy race, read.
Which thou leavest shall be magnified.
Read.
Having the confidence of their good descent.
Hey, having confidence that the holy race has not been mixed or mingled. Now look, get that, go back to the video and write what he had, Acts 17 and 26. Start it right there. Now, I'm going to touch on a lot of stuff he's going to say. And just go back
one
about
blood.
3 seconds.
Y'all have one blood. From
okay.
Couched in the Bible. So it's not biblical. Read Acts 17, 26, where Paul says, and he
so hold on, hold on, stop. Blood. We just proved that race is biblical. That's proven right there. Now, anybody don't believe that race is in the Bible and that God got a special race. And if you want to call God racist, that God is a racist. He loves his people. He chose a people that's special and peculiar. He got all types of words and names for us. You know, for his chosen people. Then I don't know what the hell to tell you. You don't believe. You don't believe. A lot of y'all only wants to read the Bible when it fits you and your agenda. But you don't want the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. All right, read. Get Acts 17 and 26. Let him finish. Hit play. Let him finish up.
One blood. We all have one blood from Adam. Every nation of men, and nation means ethnicity, race, but not race in the sense of what America has done. I don't even like using the word race. Ethnicity. Every
you know why black men do this? Weak black men do this.
Yes, weak black men.
I don't want to use race the way America use it. Because he don't want to seem to be racist. First and foremost, my brother, it's impossible for the black man in this country to be racist. We don't sit up there. We don't make no laws. Racism is a system set up to oppress another people. We don't do that. What people are we oppressing? The only people we oppress is one another. If anything, black people racist towards other black people because we oppress the hell out of each other. We ride from each other. We steal from each other. We commit adultery on each other. We covet each other's possessions. Read, hit play.
To dwell on all the face of the earth and has determined their pre-appointed times and the boundaries of their dwellings. It's a lot there in that verse that you could use for legal immigration and borders and all those things. But the part I want to really
now stop. See, for legal immigration and borders and all that thing. Now look at X17 to 26. This dude, hey, hey, this dude is just. I'm telling you, if you don't know nothing, you'll be listening to him like, yeah, this deep. This sound good. Yeah, legal immigration, borders and things. Border patrol. But for somebody that know the Bible, they're like, man, this dude going cleaning the hell off. And look, I ain't trying to destroy this brother. I'm trying to destroy the Christianity spirit in him. I pray and hope he repent because I see he is watching our videos. And he are saying some good things about what we doing. But when you add all this extra stuff up in it, we ain't had that one right there. So read that, Acts 17 to 26.
The book of Acts, chapter 7.
So I think that's the NIV version that he read. This is the King James version, y'all read.
The book of Acts, chapter 17 and verse 26. And hath made of one blood all nations of men, for to dwell on all the face of the earth, and hath determined the times before appointed.
Now look, notice, he ain't stressing on none of this. See, Christians, they just open up the Bible, and they ain't gonna say Christians. I say so-called. Y'all know I say so-called Christians. I don't think y'all Christians. We are the real Christians. Right. You know what I'm saying? Y'all in a cult called Christianity. For real, though, and that's the truth. But it's a, and have determined the times before appointed. What is the times before appointed? But read on.
And bounds of their habitation.
And bounds of their habitation. Now look, let's go to the times before. Let's go to Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 7, because Christians, so-called Christians, y'all hate the New Testament. Man, you hate the New Testament, man. Read what you got.
Deuteronomy.
I mean, the Old Testament. Y'all hate the Old Testament. Y'all want to stay in the New Testament. New Testament, New Testament, New Testament. Now, look, when Christ was walking the earth, he was preaching the Old Testament. The New Testament wasn't written yet. When Paul was sitting up there making his journeys and doing his bit, the New Testament wasn't written yet. What do you think he was quoting from? The Old Testament. Read on.
Deuteronomy chapter 32 and verse 7. Remember the days of old.
Here you go. And have determined the time before appointed. Read.
Consider the years of many generations. Ask thy father.
Who is Moses talking to? Israel. Ask thy father. Read.
And he will show thee thy elders, and they will tell thee.
Read.
When the Most High divided the nations to their inheritance.
The Most High divided the nations. He divided the nations, and he gave the nations an inheritance. Read.
He set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel.
He set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel. The Lord separated the nations, then draw the line between Israel and everybody else. He all about race. He separated all nations. He said, you know what? Hey, this is my chosen people. This is my peculiar people. This is my holy nation. And give me some other words. This is the holy seed. Then he gave them laws and told them how they to conduct themselves and how to deal and treat with the other nations. Get that real quick in 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 54. So that's what that's talking about right there. Hey, look, hold on, even before you go to 2nd Edge. Hey, get that, I sent you a video. It's called Esau Fake Love. I'm gonna show you this one blood of all nations. This Christianity, one blood of all nations. This is how they feel. We the only ones that still trying to love everybody. We need to learn how to love ourselves.
That's right.
Love your own race. Right. Instead of trying to love everybody, instead of trying to love the people that hate us. We need to be trying to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. You got that for me? It's the one, it should say Esau fake love.
Hey, Cap, the reason why he's saying the things he's saying about us is because they cannot deny the work that we're doing.
Right.
So he can't deny it, so he has to, damn, I can't, they doing it. So it's not like he really like us. So he have to kind of like, all right, what they teaching is, but yeah. I can't deny the work.
And that's what he keeps saying. What they teaching is off his head.
Yeah.
But the work is on point. And he wondering why the Christian church can't do this work. Because what you teaching, what y'all teaching is off. Nobody, look, man, look, black men tired of hearing that BS. of one blood of all nations. Right. They don't want to hear that no more. This your one blood right here. Hit play. Now look, before we pause the video, y'all know these all Christians. Yeah. And these, I know these ain't Muslims. I know these ain't Hindus. Who else? I know them ain't Buddhists. These are Christians.
Right.
Now let's see what the Christians think about Acts 17 and 26. Hit play.
You gave me a shoulder when I needed it.
You Where's your one nation at?
Where
your one blood?
One blood.
They swatted at him like
you
a flock.
Me when I and you made me laugh when I was losing it. 'Cause you are the reason why I'm still hanging on. 'Cause you are the reason why my head is still above water.
Hey Cat, what's heavy about this video? 'Cause what Christianity has done, it has everybody when they see that white demon walking down the street and grab his arm, you know what they see? They see Christ.
Yeah.
They see Caesar Borgia. But when they see that brother walking down doing the same thing, needing help because he's blind, yeah, they see a devil. Because that's what Christianity has taught our people.
Hey, dang. They don't see all blood.
They don't.
Of one
they
nation.
Don't. They see a slave and a master.
Man, they don't see all blood of one nation. They see something totally different from what black Christians see. For real, though.
Even the white dude walked up to a black man and did the same thing. And the black man was like, yeah, come on. It's like, damn. Our people destroyed.
Yeah. That was the end of the video.
I'd got you the moon and give it to you.
Now that y'all know these Christians,
know them.
I'd give my life for
get
you.
The hell off me, nigga.
Figure it out.
Oh man, but look, what the hell with these folks? 'Cause guess what? God is our God.
That's right.
And Jesus the Christ is coming back to save us. And only us, the Israelites, and blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the Israelites the Bible speaks of. And I get that Black Lives video, one blood of every nation. One blood of every nation, Black Lives video. Let's show you some more Christians in action. See, these Christians right here. But see, and all praise to the Most High. Hey, we putting in work. We doing the work. We sitting up there, we casting down. We get that real quick in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 4. 2 Corinthians 10 and 4. At this casting down imaginations, get that real quick. Start at verse 3. All praise to the Most High, the Lord have put the Spirit on our bishops, our deacons, our captains, our officers, our soldiers. You know what I'm saying? Hell, the brothers and sisters, everybody that's sitting up here pushing this truth forward. You know what I'm saying? And pushing it to the ends of the earth. Read what you got.
2 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 3. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh.
So y'all got to understand, man, this battle, this ain't the flesh. Even with Esau, these fake Christians, they got a spirit up in them. And you seen within that video, hey, every time that white dude walked up pretending to be blind, they always helped him. They let him hold his arm. But when the black dude did it, that's how you know this is a spiritual battle. This is a war. This is a spiritual war. Read on.
For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
And the weapons of our warfare ain't carnal. That's why you see us blitzing here, blitzing there, blitzing that, blitzing this. Read on.
But mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds.
And look, when we blitz these places, when we go to camp every day, when we teach every day, we're pulling down strongholds.
Right.
And look, we sitting up here and we delivering blow after blow after blow to Christianity. Blow after blow after blow to Satan. And y'all wonder why Satan on our head right now. It said he gonna come down having great wrath. Brothers and sisters wonder why they having money problems all of a sudden. My money was good. You having marriage problems all of a sudden. My marriage was good. You having all types of issues all of a sudden. Why? Satan pissed. Because guess what? You witnessing the death of Christianity. Keep going.
Verse 5. Casting down imaginations.
Man, we casting down imaginations. We casting down Christmas. Even everybody know Christmas ain't of God now. Some people just want to do it for the hell of it. It make me feel good. But you going to die feeling good.
It's for the kids.
It's for the kids. That's a damn lie. Why they, if it's for the kids, why they mad when they don't get what they want for Christmas?
Right.
I'm upset. I wanted such and such for Christmas. Now you're upset. Man, get the hell out of here. Read on.
Casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God.
Every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, we casting down. Now look, get that One Blood, Every Nation, Black Lives Matter video. Here you go, y'all. Here you go. Hey, now look, if y'all look at the video, you better see Christians in action once again. It play.
Black Lives Matter. Everybody's talking about this new thing called Black Lives Matter. But this is what it is really about. All lives matter.
No, lives don't matter in this world and age. I don't know if you know that, but unless you're white and pretty and white and then like you don't give no bigots a fuck about you.
And see, here you go. And how the video. Here you go. Negro cooning once again. Yeah, Black Lives Matter. Yeah, Black Lives. There ain't no Black Lives Matter. All lives matter. Here come here come Esau. Hell no, Black lives don't matter. And you know, this is a Christian.
Yeah.
That is a Christian. Mm-hmm. That's your Southern Baptist, Methodist Pentecostal, coach it, Emmanuel. Help me out.
The blue
coach it Emmanuel, Episcopalian, Bartholomew Christian. Black lives matter. Black lives matter. No, it ain't Black lives matter. All lives matter. So she just shut him down. Finish it up, y'all. Finish it up.
I'm set, though. I'm good. Yeah, this motherfucker, though.
Do you hear this shit?
It's rough.
This is going on Facebook, so y'all heard this. And it's true, though. That's the worst fucking part. I'm drunk right now, so I'm just speaking like the illiterate truth. This is what many Americans think about this. I hope I never see this. Hey, notice she said she's drunk right now. Hey, now, remember what the scripture said about drunkenness. Get that the furnace proof, the tip. This is a rock 33. What you been saying, Cabo?
He said many Americans think like this. No Negro. White Americans.
White Americans.
Like
he knew that. He just tried to cover it.
But look, what happened to Acts 17 and 26?
Right.
This all blood of one nation. I thought we was one nation. Your life don't matter. Hmm. She telling you that. And then she going to say, I'm kind of drunk right now. She telling you the truth.
Yeah, she said that.
She drunk and went up and told the truth. Yeah. That's Sirach 33. Let me find it. It said, the furnace proved the edge by dipping. Something like that. So drunkenness. Sirach 31. And let's jump down to verse, let me see. Start at verse 12, I think. Hold on, no, not 12. Let me see some. The furnace proved the edge. Y'all look, all right, verse 26.
The book of Sirach, chapter 31 and verse 26.
Read.
The furnace proveth the edge by dipping.
So you know the furnace hot when you take your finger and go, and you were like, whoa! Man, that thing hot. Read on.
So doth wine the hearts of the proud by drunkenness.
You see that? Esau prideful. Remember in Obadiah chapter 1 through 4. It say, so do wine the hearts of the proud by drunkenness. When they get drunk, they go, hey, look, they're going to show you who they is. Yeah. They're going to prove to you that they're going to prove to you, oh, your life don't matter. Oh, yeah, look, I know I'm drunk right now, but it's the truth. She can't say it, but it's the truth. And go back a little bit when she can't say it, it's the truth. Then go back about 10, 15 seconds.
She put it in her
mind and everything. Blame it on the alcohol.
Esau had a true feelings when they drunk.
Just a little bit. Yeah, go back right there.
This is what this is what many Americans think about this.
This is legit.
I hope I never see this person again, and I hope they never see me again. I might not have to post this.
Go back. Because he said, this is true. You can start from the beginning. It ain't nothing but a 40, 50-second video.
Black Lives Matter. Everybody's talking about this new thing called Black Lives Matter. But this is what it is really about. All lives matter.
No, lives don't matter in this world and age. I don't know if you know that, but unless you're white and pretty and white and then like you don't give no bigots a fuck about you. You're gonna die and you're gonna be shot probably by a police officer.
You hear this show?
I'm set though, I'm good. Yeah, this motherfucker though, he's pretty screwed, yeah. Sorry.
Hey, you hear this shit?
It's rough.
You hear this shit? This is going on Facebook.
Look, she holding his soul and she touching him in there. See, some of y'all want to be free with these people. See, that's why I say never trust thy enemy. She doing all of this. She telling the truth. She all like this, getting him a pat on the back. Like, yeah, it's true. You're going to get shot by a cop. You're probably going to die, get shot by a cop. And the statistics of that is pretty high.
Hey, he was shot, which she was saying. He wasn't ready for that.
Yeah.
His whole demeanor changed.
Now, give me that other video real quick. We're going to drop that one. Because I'm wasting too much time. Get the Jack Esau feeding Jake. The one, that one. Get that one for me. Esau feeding Jake. This all blood of one nation. Here you go.
Oh, gosh.
Hold on. Stop. let me disclaimer. Y'all know this Christian. These Christians. Hey, look, I know a Christian when I see him. That's a Christian. He a Christian, she a Christian.
Yep.
All right.
This dog was adopted.
Hit play.
It's a rescue dog.
It's a rescue dog.
He know you're all good in one nation, guy. Hey, they look at you just like they look at the dog. For real, though. Now, look, let's go right back to Acts 17 and 26. Because this is what he's going to miss when you go back to the brother video. You know, Christianity or these so-called teachers or these so-called pastors, they choose one verse and they just stop there. What about verse 27, my brother? Go to Acts 17, verse 27.
The book of Acts, chapter 17 and verse 27. That they should seek the Lord.
That they shall seek the Lord. Who shall seek the Lord? Remember it said that when you read Acts 17 verse 26, it said made bounds of their habitation. Then we went into Deuteronomy 32 and 8, and it showed you set the bounds according to the people of the number of the children of Israel. So the dirt is talking about the children of Israel. And it said that they shall seek the Lord. The children of Israel shall seek the Lord. Read.
If happily they might feel after him.
Read.
And find him.
And it say, and find him, read.
Though he be not far from every one of us.
It say, though he be not far off from every one of us. Why is he not far off from every one of us? Get that in Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 7. Why is he not far off from every one of us? And then I ain't through with this Acts 17 yet. I'm not through.
Deuteronomy chapter 4 and verse 7. For what nation is there so great?
Read.
Who hath God so nigh unto them?
Who is nigh to God? What nation is not far from God? Who is the Lord talking to in Acts chapter 17? The Lord is talking to the Israelites. Read on.
As the Lord our God is in all things that we call upon him
all for. All we got to do is call upon him. But you got to repent. He ain't far from us. All you got to do is repent and apply the commandments. Repent and keep the commandments of God. Now go to 2 Ezra chapter 6, verse 54. But this shows you what Christianity do. They'll take these scriptures. They don't know nothing about the history because they don't keep the commandments. They're going to stay away from the Old Testament because they're going to read, thou shalt not commit adultery. They're going to read about whoremongering. They're going to read about the dress code. They're going to read about what to eat and not to eat. Read this, 2 Ezra 6 and 54.
2 Ezra chapter 6 and verse 54. And after these, Adam also, whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures.
Read.
Of him come we all.
You see that? So this saying the same thing in Acts 17 and 26. From Adam come us all, read.
And the people also whom thou hast chosen.
And the people also whom thou hast chosen. Remember, what was the word that he used in Acts chapter 17, verse 26? And have determined the times before appointed and the bounds of their habitation. And then when you read in Deuteronomy 32, verse 8 again, he said the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel, the people whom he have chosen. God separated all the nations and then draw a line between them and the nation of Israel. Read on.
Verse 55. All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sakes.
God made the world for the Israelites' sakes. Period. You can read about that in Jeremiah when he said, look, if I destroy the sun and moon, then Israel will cease from being a nation before me. So if you gotta, y'all gotta understand how deep that is. If the Lord take away the sun, everything died. All life died. You dying too. That means, so the Lord basically said, if I take away the sun, I'm taking away the world, because the world was created for Israel. Simple as that. Read on.
As for the other people, which also come from Adam.
As for the other people, remember he said the bounds according to the number of the children of Israel. It's saying the same thing, just different prophets saying it in different ways. Read on.
Thou hast said that they are nothing.
They are nothing to God. Talking about some race idolatry. The Lord said they ain't nothing to them. Read on.
But be like unto spittle.
He said they be like spit. You know when you try to get deep down. You know you got that big glob down. That's what they is, that big glob. I think I can hack some up, right? You know if you can hack some up, that's what they is. They hack, you can hack up. Read on.
And hast likened the abundance of them unto a drop that falleth from a vessel.
He said the abundance of them is talking about all of them. Talking about when he separated the sons of Adam, when he set the bounds. Okay, he drew a line between Israel and the other nations. The other nations, he said the abundance of them, the abundance of them, he likened them to a drop that falleth from the vessel. Now, go back to their video.
And he has made from one blood. One blood. We all have one blood from Adam. Every nation of men, and nation means ethnicity, race, but not race in the sense of what America has done. I don't even like using the word race. Ethnicity. Every ethnicity of men to dwell on all the face of the earth and has determined their pre-appointed times and the boundaries of their dwellings. It's a lot there in that verse that you could use for legal immigration.
Now remember, and that's what Paul was quoting. It said, it has determined the pre-appointed time. What was the pre-appointed time? The Lord dividing Israel from the other nations. But he ain't going to say that. Right. He talking about all blood, one nation. Right. Hit play.
All those things. But a part I want to really hit on is how God has made from one blood every nation. So when you look at that and you take into consideration also Galatians 3:28.
Oh, here we go. Did
you know, you know they love to go to Galatians.
Slave nor free.
That's the dude, John 3:16.
For you are all one in Christ Jesus, meaning that once you're in Christ, you're one. There's unity between everybody else.
Now notice how they'll quote the scriptures, but they give no real explanation. And then they give a pseudo breakdown of what they think the scripture is talking about. Now get that real quick in Galatians chapter 3 and verse 28. And notice, he ain't going to read, keep playing. Let's see if he's going to get verse 29 real quick.
Amongst yourself. So quit trying to have factions and divisions amongst yourself. So when you take those two verses in context, you know, God is not a respecter of persons. God does not limit his salvation just to a certain sect of people. He doesn't. That was the old covenant to get Christ into the earth. And that
all right,
was the
pause. Bruh, explain the neither Jew nor Greek, man. Explain it. Break the scripture down. To hell. We want some understanding here. And see, this is why the Lord said, look, though I give you the bread of virtue and the water of fiction, your teachers ain't going to be back into a corner no more. Hey, look, we going to give you the understanding of these verses when they come out. Get that real quick in Galatians 3 and 28.
The book of Galatians, chapter 3 and verse 28. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither bond nor free. There is neither male nor female, for ye are all one in Christ Jesus.
He said, there is neither Jew nor Greek. Now, when it's talking about the Jew, remember, you had those Jews that grew up. You had those Jews that, well, I'm trying to see what word I was going to use, but I'll say it like this. You had the repentant Israelites. You had the Jews. They still had the temple. They still were making the sacrifices. And then you had the Greeks. The Greeks was Hellenized Jews. You can read about that in what? 2 Maccabees 6. You can read about that in 2 Maccabees 6. Now read that again for me.
Galatians chapter 3 and verse 28. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither bond nor free.
So you said had the Jews that were still keeping the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High. They were still offering the sacrifices. They were still doing everything according to the Levitical priesthood. And then it say, nor Greek. You had those Hellenized Jews. They was converted into Greeks during the time of Alexander the Great. It say, there is neither bond nor free, because you had freeborn Israelites, and you had Israelites that were still slaves. Read on.
There is neither male nor female.
Read.
For ye are all one in Christ Jesus.
So he was just basically saying, Paul was saying, no matter what condition you in, or what you call, you all the Israelites. That's what he was saying. I'm telling you. Y'all all the Israelites. We all the Israelites in Christ. Like we what we say, Israel united in what? Christ. Read verse 29 now, because they ain't going to read this.
Verse 29. And if you be Christ.
And if you Israel, or you the Israelites, if you united in Christ, read on.
Then are ye Abraham's seed.
He say, then are you Abraham's seed, read.
And heirs according to the promise.
Now let's see who Abraham's seed is. Get that real quick in Romans chapter 9. See, nothing ain't going to change. Because people be like, well, he butchered it. No, all he was saying, no matter what condition you in, no matter what state you in, we all Israel. That's exactly what he's saying. In Christ. Because remember, Romans 9 and 6 say they are not all Israel. They claim to be Israel. So you got some wicked Negroes around here. Hey, look, it's some people on my friend list. I don't know how the hell they got on there. They got names. They got Israelite names. But sisters in pants, taking booty shots, all types of stuff. Brothers doing all types of stuff. And I'm like, what the hell? No, they ain't Israel. They ain't one with us. They ain't one in Christ. They ain't keeping no commandments. Well, what I say again? Get Romans 9 and 7.
The book of Romans chapter 9 and verse 7. Neither, because they are the seed of Abraham, are they all children.
So that's because you come from the seed of Abraham. That'll make you a child of what? God? Read on.
But in Isaac shall thy seed be called.
He said, in Isaac shall thy seed be called, read.
That is, they which are the children of the flesh.
That's because you come from Abraham, read.
These are not the children of God.
They don't make you a child of God, read on.
But the children of the promise are counted for the seed.
The children of the promise are counted. Who was the promises made with? What is wrong with y'all men in the Christian church? What the hell is wrong with you Christian pastors? You had something, Cap?
Hey, yeah. I get the scripture real quick.
Yes, sir.
Hey, go to Acts 13, because the so-called Christian will read Acts 17, but forgot what Paul said in Acts 13. Yeah. Get that Acts 13, read verse 22, just to go along with what Cap was breaking out.
The book of Acts, chapter 13 and verse 22.
And this is why Peter said, this is why Peter had to say in the book of, I think it's 1 Peter 3 and 15, Paul's writings are hard to be understood for those that are unlearned and unstable. That's why Christians will, like you said, will isolate scriptures, will read certain things, but you forgot a few chapters before what Paul said. Read that.
The book of Acts, chapter 13 and verse 22. And when he had removed him, he raised up unto them David to be their king, to whom also he gave testimony and said.
So this is Paul speaking in Antioch, just like in Acts 17. He was speaking, and I believe it was, what, Thessalonica? He was speaking in. He was basically addressing the Israelites that were there. And this is what he said. Read.
I have found David, the son of Jesse, a man after mine own heart, which shall fulfill all my will.
Watch this. Read.
Of this man's seed.
Of this man's seed, of David's seed, his sperm, read.
Hath God according to his promise.
Hath God according to his promise, read.
Raise unto Israel.
Unto who?
Unto Israel.
No, all nations.
Israel.
All people.
Israel.
Read on.
A Savior, Jesus.
A Savior, Jesus. So when you get to Acts 17, Paul ain't switched up what he said. He just said it differently. And that goes back to Galatians where he talked about the promise. It goes back to Romans. Paul ain't never switched up. What has happened is Christianity has switched it up. Christianity has switched the understanding up.
Hey, Cap, also, since they love the New Testament so much, right? They love Christ. Matthew's 1 gives you a distinctive breakdown of the seed that he's talking about. We go to Matthew.
Nationality.
It's telling you exactly where he comes from. The seed from Abraham. So what are you talking about? Our people don't want to read, man. They oblivious. They want to find something that's going to cater to their narrative. And the Bible destroys everything they cater to.
Also, think about it. They said the Old Testament done away with, right? But they keep bringing up, what did they say? How you say it?
Racial idolatry,
right? They keep saying this, but how you the Old Testament done away with? You can't, sin is done. You can't. If you ask them, do you do Christmas? Yes, they do Christmas. That's idolatry, sir.
Yeah.
Do you worship on Sunday? No, and then they gonna tell you what the Old Testament done away with. So you can't pick and choose. Now hold on. How you going to tell us we idolaters, but you idolaters?
Not only do they pick and choose, especially with their Sunday stuff, they go into script. They create a scripture to support that. Now, Danielle, I just sent you some. Because when you was bringing out the scripture, you made me think, how many times is the term Israel listed in the Bible?
Right.
And I want you to post that. Now, this is something I Googled real quick. And y'all got to understand, y'all, this is the age of information. You shouldn't even be a damn fool in today's time.
So you're a fool by choice.
If you're a damn fool in today, you choose to be a fool. That's why we keep telling y'all, y'all got to stop smoking weed, man. Stop smoking weed. It ain't helping you. It's making you dumb idiots.
Hey, ChatGPT will teach you any damn thing. Well,
I sent it to Danielle.
ChatGPT will teach you everything.
Sure. I sent it to him on Telegram. It's a photo. Yeah, it's a photo on Telegram. I sent it to your personal. Ah, hold on. You didn't get it. I don't know who I sent this to there. Hold on, I'm going to send it again. Hey, somebody got a photo. All right, I just sent it. So read that real quick. While he's getting that, read Galatians 3:28 all the way down to 29 this time. Because that's something they don't do. That is something that they don't do. Read.
The book of Galatians, chapter 3 and verse 28. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither bond nor free. There is neither male nor female. For ye are all one in Christ Jesus.
So no matter what you call, if you keeping the commandment and the faith of Christ, he's sitting up there telling them, look, you Israel, that's who you are. Read on.
And if you be Christ, then...
If you Israelites repent and keeping the commandments in the faith of Christ, read.
Then are ye Abraham's seed.
Why? Remember Romans 6, some of y'all Israelites wicked as hell. We call y'all Gentiles. We up here calling some of you wicked like Gentiles because you still in a Gentile state of mind. Read.
Then are you Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise.
And heirs according to the promise. Who the promises was made with? Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and the Israelites. So get that real quick. Now this, I just Googled this real quick. And still with that racial idolatry stuff. And I typed in, how many times is Israel mentioned in the Bible? This dude said, I have not personally counted myself, but according to Authorized King James Version, Israel in the Bible, the term Israel is mentioned 2,319 individual times.
Hey, Cap, you know.
I didn't know he can read that from over there.
Yeah, okay. He can read it from over there.
All right.
Hey, I had to search it too, because, you know, we like Cap said with the AI.
Yeah.
I searched it. It says 2,576 times.
Wow. 2,576 times.
Even more.
So what Bibles they read? What Bibles you read? Because this one nation that it got mentioned 2,500 and how many? 36 times? So what Bible y'all read, man? All right, where we at? Go back to the brother video. See, these Christian lies got to go, man. They got to stop. I ain't going to have enough time to go through all that. You right. I put too much stuff down. It ain't happening. No, not that video. That's the one blood all nations.
What's up, IT?
What we got?
Y'all all right?
Same video with the brother.
Acts 17 video.
They ain't
got to
download it?
No,
they got to download it. All right, while they're getting that, give me Jeremiah 23 and 21. Because these folks ain't sent of God. Read that real quick. And go back probably about 15 seconds on that video, because he finna say something about the old covenant and the new covenant. See, they gonna throw a lot of stuff up in there, and you gotta be careful with people. That's why people be saying, why won't y'all just talk? Why you gotta read the scriptures? We gonna read the scriptures every time. We ain't just talking. We read the scriptures. The Lord told us the minister has the ability that he give it, and he gave us the scriptures, and that's how we gonna minister. All right, where we at? Read that real quick.
Jeremiah chapter 23 and verse 21. I have not sent these prophets.
The Lord ain't sent these prophets. Read.
Yet they teaching.
Read on.
I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesy.
In the Christian church, that's all you heard them pastor say. God came to me and spoke to me last night. God gave me a message. God said this. God, you hear that in the Christianity. The Lord said, look, I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran. I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesy. They prophesy. The Lord ain't dealing with them. Why ain't he dealing with y'all? Y'all ain't keeping the commandments. All right, now here play.
Verse in context. You know, God is not...
Now look, we kept the verses in context. What context did he keep the verse in? It was no context at all. Matter of fact, they even keep it further in context with two of the verses we reread. We made sure we went to the next verse under that to prove the exact point, and we could have kept going. But keep, hit the big play.
He does not limit his salvation just to a certain sect of people. He doesn't. That was the old covenant to get Christ into the earth, and now with the new covenant, it's open to everybody.
Now look, get there to Hebrews 9. So go back real quick again, because I'm going to make sure I ain't been a butcher his words. Go back another 15 seconds. Listen to this, y'all. I want everybody to hear what he's about to say.
Sent Paul to the Gentiles. But we have to have a conversation, because I've seen more black men united doing positive
stuff. Now go back,
son.
I think you went up. Go back. Go back. All right, hit play.
He doesn't. That was the old covenant. All right,
go back to the earth,
and now with the new covenant, it's open to everyone.
Another 20 seconds or so. All right.
All one in Christ Jesus, meaning that once you're in Christ, you're one. There's unity between everybody else. No more division.
Yeah, Israel became one in Christ because the Lord did what? Broke the walls of partition between the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom. The Israelites that was Hellenized and the Israelites that was already keeping the commandments. Now they all one in Christ because he came and did what? Died for their sins. But hit play.
Have factions and divisions amongst yourself. So when you take those two verses in context, you know, God is not a respecter of persons. God does not limit his salvation just to a certain sect of people.
That's a lie. Pause. Get that in Matthew 1 and 21. He does not limit his salvation to a certain... And you read that in Acts 13 and 23. What Bible is they reading? Matthew 1 and 21 real quick. And that's why I said, I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran. He said, I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesy. He played. I mean, read it, bro.
Yep.
Matthew chapter 1 and verse 21. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins.
It say he gonna save his people. His people from their sins. Go Acts 13 again. His people, Israel. Who is his people? Acts 13, 23.
Acts chapter 13 and verse 23. Of this man's seed hath God, according to his promise, raised unto Israel a Savior, Jesus.
So salvation is limited to one people. What Bible is y'all read? And see, this Christianity. It's certain verses that Christianity already got ready to defend their doctrine. It ain't gonna help them though. It ain't gonna help you. Why? Because the Lord said, thy teachers ain't going to be removed into a corner no more. There's a new breed of black man on the earth. And you see, he said that out his own mouth.
He did.
There's a new breed of black man on earth. He play.
Was the old covenant to get Christ into the earth, and now with the new covenant, it's open to everybody.
That's a lie.
The Lord sent Paul to
the new covenant. Pause it. The new covenant, he said, and see, this is what I'm saying. This is why you got to take your time to dissect this stuff. Yep. What you got, officer?
Can I get this scripture? It's in Galatians 3. Go to Galatians. It's saying in the same.
Verse 16?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Go to verse 23. It's in the same chapter. It's right there. It's talking about the new and old. Right here. Read that.
Galatians chapter 3 and verse 23. But before faith came.
Before faith came. Before Christ came. Read.
We were kept under the law.
We were kept under the law. Everybody wasn't kept under the law. The Israelites was kept under the law. Read.
Shut up unto the faith, which should afterwards be revealed.
Read.
Wherefore, the law was our schoolmaster.
The law was our schoolmaster. The first covenant. Read.
To bring us unto Christ.
The second covenant. It's talking about the Israelites. Period. No other, not all the nations. That's it.
Get Hebrews 9, verse 15. Because he said the old covenant the new covenant is now for everybody. That's a lie. Get Hebrews 9 and 15 first.
Hebrews chapter 9 and verse 15. And for this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament.
He said for this cause, Christ is the mediator of the New Testament. Read.
That by means of death,
read.
For the redemption of the transgressions.
For the redemption of the transgressions, read.
That were under the first testament.
My brother, who was under the first testament? Another name for testament is covenant. Who was under the first covenant? Read on.
They which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance.
Why do we keep hearing about a chosen people, a called people, a holy people, a bounds and lines that's being set between a people? It say, they which are called might receive the promise. Why do we keep hearing about a people receiving a promise of eternal inheritance? Now go from there to Hebrews chapter 8. You know what? I don't even want to read the whole thing, Hebrews 8. Through 8 through 10. But now read it. What you got?
Get Galatians 3. We can stay in the same chapter and destroy
this.
We
do this all day.
Galatians 3 and 19.
Hey, and that's why Peter said, you so-called Christians, y'all don't understand.
Paul. Y'all better get back, man.
You talk about the mediator, right? Galatians 3 and 18.
The book of Galatians chapter 3 and verse 18. For if the inheritance be of the law.
3 and 19.
Verse 19. Wherefore then serveth the law? It was added because of transgressions, till the seed should come to whom the promise was made.
Uh-huh.
And it was ordained by angels in the hand of a mediator.
Oh my God.
Wow.
All in the same chapter.
Same chapter. So he didn't read 10 verses up. He went straight down to verse 28 and said, what the hell was verse 29?
Hey, he Googled Jews and Gentiles, and that's what they gave
Jews
it to
and Gentiles.
That's it.
It's neither bond nor free. It's neither Jew nor Greek.
But we all one. It ain't male or female. So you mean to tell me it really ain't males and females, bro? See, and this how that's what I was just going to say. This where this damn gender identity stuff come from. Christianity. Yep. Christianity.
Hebrews 8 and 8. These Christians the one that's passing those.
Talk about it ain't no male or female. They use this for gender identity stuff. The damn Transformers and all of that. Hebrews 8 and 8.
Hebrews chapter 8 and verse 8. For finding fault with them.
Who is the them he found fault with? The Israelites, read.
He saith, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel.
He said he going to make a new covenant with Esau. That's what he said. Now, read, you supposed to say the house of Israel, bro. Come on, man. We in camp mode right now. Okay.
When I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah.
And the house of Judah. He going to make the new, not with Esau. He going to make the new covenant with the Chinese, the Arabs. He said, I'm going to make the new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. Read.
Verse 9. Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers.
With their fathers, them, all these present. Since you damn Christians love pronouns so much, right. What happened to all these possessive pronouns right here? Them, their, his. But read on.
Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers, in the day when I took them by the hand to lead them.
Their fathers took them to lead them. Read on.
Out of the land of Egypt.
Who he led out of the land of Egypt? The Israelites, read on.
Because they continued not in my covenant.
Who the covenant was made with? Because the covenant wasn't made with the heathen that ran out behind us. The covenant wasn't made with them. Read on.
And I regarded them not, saith the Lord.
Read on.
For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel.
Make with Esau.
Israel.
Amen.
Israel.
No, the Arabs.
Israel.
He said, this is the covenant that I'm going to make with the house of Israel. The new covenant ain't for everybody, my brother. So what the hell are you getting that from?
So it wasn't one blood, all nations.
One blood, all nations. Well, we already seen what that one blood, all nations, have the white woman feed the dog first, then take the walk. The irony of it, she had watermelon.
Damn.
The irony of this thing. She had a whole damn watermelon. Like, yeah, this nigger coon. Watch this, y'all. Watch this, friends. Got See, you. This is what happens when you get your nigger. Look, I'm going to feed the dog first, and then I'm going to feed the nigger. All blood, one nation. All right, go, man. Read up.
For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel.
Okay.
After those days, saith the Lord, I will put my laws into their mind and write them upon their hearts, and I will be to them a God.
He said, I'm going to be to them a God. Read.
And they shall be to me a people.
Them. They, der, them, they, der. Man, come on, man. All these, he's sitting up there. God let you know who he for. Now, if I was in the Christian church, I'd be pissed off right now if I wasn't this. I know I'm Israel. I'm good. Right. When I'm listening to this stuff, I'm like, yeah, all praise to the Most High. He going to be to us a God. We going to be to him a people. He set bounds for us. We chosen. We procure you. All praises to the Most High. Now go right back to Jeremiah 23 and 21. That's why the Lord said, I ain't sent them. I ain't sent them. You're not sent. Y'all need to just fall back.
Shut the hell up.
And shut the hell up. Shut up. Jeremiah 23 and 21 again.
Jeremiah chapter 23 and verse 21. I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran. I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesy.
The Lord said he ain't sent you, but you running with it, though. You running with that BS that you done learned. Read on.
But if they had stood in my counsel.
If you stand in the counsel, if you listen to what we actually trying to say, if you listen to the Bible, instead of sitting up there talking about racial idolatry and whatever the hell the other terms y'all coming up with to sit up there to try to defame us. Read on.
And had caused my people to hear my word.
And cause the people to hear the words. What a good understanding of the Bible. Cause look, I'm gonna show you. This is how you know they ain't sent. Get that Pastor in the Holy Ghost video real quick. Pastor in the Holy Ghost. Pastor in the Holy Ghost. This is how you know they ain't sent. The pastor been to tell you what the Holy Ghost is right here and there. Now look, we been to play a game called What Scripture Is This? For real.
Hooking on to God, and everything that come up and down the street got to be a child of God and got to worship with God. These ain't drunk by people. This is the Holy Ghost.
Hold on, stop.
You have to have a conversation.
Pause that. Go right back to Jeremiah. And look, hey. Anytime we have one of these videos, we're going to read this. Jeremiah 23 and 21. Go.
Book of Jeremiah, chapter 23 and verse 21. I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran.
They were literally running in place.
They were running, man.
They were literally running in place, bro. He said, I ain't sent these prophets, bro. But yet they ran.
Oh, my God.
Read on. Oh.
I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesied.
He said, I ain't spoken to them. But they prophesied. For real though, Pastor, what scripture is this? I need the scripture. Shame. All right, now get the other one. Pastor straight cool.
So look at this turn on
they
the
crazy road. As hell. They in the middle of the parking lot. Tap dancing and running in place.
Hey, so this on a Sunday morning, right? So you just can turn on the Holy Spirit Sunday morning, and then the rest of the week you just doing a horse.
But you mean the Holy Spirit couldn't get that Edomite with no rhythm? Because the Edomite was the only one that was off beat with the
step. That was funny.
He was
out. Oh, man. You got the pastor straight coding. Now, if y'all go down that list that I took y'all, the next video, all the videos that I'm calling up next, they should be all in the line back to back. Pastor Straight Conan. So read that while we getting that Pastor Straight Conan. Jeremiah 23 and 21.
Jeremiah chapter 23 and verse 21. I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran.
So the Lord ain't sent you. But y'all running though, read.
I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesy.
He said, I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesy. So they going out here, they don't got no understanding of the Bible.
None.
This is our wisdom in the sight of the nation. The Bible was given to Israel and only Israel. So look, we got the video. Hey, let's hit play. Now look, check this out. Here you go once again.
You ought to tell three people he's still there. He is here. He is here. He is here. Ooh. Ooh.
You better have a heart attack.
That's what it was saying.
What scripture?
Read. Wow. Read Jeremiah 23 and 21 again. Hey, look, even the brother, look, hey, we better get to the point what the brother said, though, because the brother said something major in his video. And that's why I titled the class this. Because I was going to talk about something totally different. I was going to get at our sisters. Uh-huh. But don't worry about it. I'll get y'all next week. I'll get y'all next week. Y'all might be seeing me the next couple weeks. All right, where we at, read.
Jeremiah chapter 23 and verse 21. I have not sent these prophets.
The Lord didn't send them prophets, read.
Yet they ran.
They said, but yet they ran. Read.
I have not spoken to them.
Read.
Yet they prophesied.
Pastor, what scripture is this? Everything we do is based upon scripture. We brother be like, hey, why y'all stand up and face the east when you pray? Oh, let's go to 1 Kings chapter 8. Why the women got their head covered? Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 11. The stuff that we do is scriptural. Why y'all got security set up in the Bible? Let's go to 2 Chronicles chapter 32. It's scriptural. But what scripture is this? Now get the next video. This is this the Conan Deacon? Yeah, this the Conan Deacon right here. The Conan Deacon.
look like he got a demon on.
He's so damn old as spirit, right, Cap? Why she don't want that? She's
like, hell no.
He put that on her. But he's supposed
to. Was he shooting her with the Holy Spirit?
She went with the program. Hey, it was a brother. Hey, you remember that brother? Man, what's his name? You remember the brother that had the white van? The white van in Memphis, 1661 Lamar. Damn. We seen him in D.C. last year when we was blessing. I forgot his name. But remember when he told us the story about how the pastor used to go and touch people, you had to play along with it. And he ran around, you had to run around the church. So he said one day the pastor came, he would look at the pastor. The pastor touched him. He was like, hell no, I ain't going down today. I'm tired. He said the pastor touched him again. He was like, hell no, I'm not going down today. The pastor hit him again. He was like, yeah, he didn't want to make the pastor look bad. So he just went on down. He told him another story about how everybody just got to running around church. He's sitting down. He's like, I ain't getting up. I ain't running around the church. So they ran around. They grabbed him. He just got up and ran around the church. Pastor, read that in Jeremiah 23 and 21.
Jeremiah chapter 23 and verse 21. I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran. I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesied.
You see that? The Lord ain't dealing with these folks. Pastor, what scripture is this? For real though. All right, look, get the one praying to Esau. Praying to Esau.
Your children are dying. All great fruit you do, like Mother Mary at the foot of the cross, I pray for your fruit of the womb. Receive the fruit of the womb. You, the businessman, you receive progress because Psalm 90 says, whatever you place your hand shall be successful.
Now, they didn't do nothing in chapter 7, verse 20. Pastor, what scripture is this, Pastor? What scripture that tells you to get on your knees and pray to a white statue of Jesus? Get Deuteronomy 7 and 25 real quick. I'm going to show you what the scripture tells you not to do. What you say, Cap?
He definitely ain't reading what's in that hand of his right now.
Hey, but you know, I'm going to tell you something. The crazy part about you know this brother from Africa. They reads. Mm-hmm. He knows it's in there. He don't give a. They follow Christianity. Follows the world. Wow. They follow Satan. They do their own thing. The Lord say, don't do what they do. The Lord say, don't eat unclean food. Hey, look, did you send in the video of the chitterlings?
Yes.
Oh man,
that's I couldn't.
Hey, I had another video I want to send too. Hold on, let me find that slave food. I don't got that much time, man. Yeah. I'm gonna leave them alone.
Talking about idolatry.
Yeah.
This is idolatry right here.
This is idolatry. But they ain't making no video talking about this. They talking about what we doing. Right. The way we shaking the earth, impacting the earth, casting down imagination, pulling down strongholds. That's what we doing. All right, get that in Deuteronomy 7 and 25.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 25. The graven image of their gods.
The graven image of their God. That ain't Jesus. Jesus is a black man, according to the Bible. Everybody know this. This is the age of information. If you still got a white Jesus in your church, if you still bowing down and praying to a white Jesus, something is wrong with you. Everybody know Jesus is black in his day and time. Y'all just want to deny it. Now all of a sudden, color don't matter. Now all of a sudden, Jesus is all colors. How in the hell Jesus go from being white? They start off saying he white, and then you sit up there and want to turn Jesus into all colors now. Because we saying he black. Or the Bible describes him as a black man. Read.
The graven image of their gods shall ye burn with fire.
That's what you're supposed to do. Burn it with fire. But like it said, I have not sent these prophets. Because if he sent those prophets, guess what we would have did? The prophets burning that thing down just like we were burning it down in Sierra Leone. Just like we were burning it down in Uganda. Just like we was burning it down in Tabernacles. That's what the prophets do. They're going to burn it down. Read on.
Thou shalt not desire the silver or the gold that is on them.
Okay. So that's it right there. So look, that's idolatry. And like the officer Yahweh was saying, why they don't never talk about that? Why they don't never talk about Easter? Why they don't never talk about Christmas and the 4th of July and all the rest of these idolatrous holidays they celebrate? All right, we'll get the next video. Well, I forgot which one. Oh, man. Hold on. No, this was too early. Now look, all right, read on down. Go back to Jeremiah 23, verse 21.
Jeremiah chapter 23 and verse 21.
Okay, let me run through some of this stuff. Read.
I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran.
Read.
I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesied.
Read.
But if they had stood in my counsel.
Repent, because the prophets, we back on the earth. That's we taking right. this thing over. Look, video, we got online classes more than 3 times a day, 7 days a week. We out on the streets every day, all over the earth. We in your city every week, blitzing. We're doing all manner of work on this earth. We're in all the different countries now. We're spreading throughout the globe the true gospel of Christ. This is the true gospel. Read on.
But if they had stood in my counsel and had caused my people to hear my word.
He said, but if they had stood at my counsel and have caused my people to hear my words, read.
Then they should have turned them from their evil way.
He said, you're supposed to turn them from their evil way. We know you ain't sent because you ain't turning the people from their evil way. Christianity supports feminism. Christianity supports homosexuality. So Christianity is in agreement with idolatry. Read on.
And from the evil of their doings.
You will sit up there and get the people to repent from the evil of their doings. You'll never hear these folks talking about calling out people to repent and keep the commandments. You never hear it. They always talking about how we sitting up there butchering the scripture. No, you butchering the scripture.
That's right.
God ain't sent you. Stop. Keep your mouth shut. Let the real men of the Lord do the work. Read on.
Am I a God at hand?
He's saying, I am God at hand. Read.
Saith the Lord. And not a God afar off.
He's going right back to the Acts chapter 17 that he brought out. The Lord said, I am God ahead and not far off. Not far off from who? He ain't far off from the Israelites. Read on.
Can any hide himself in a secret place that I shall not see him?
And look, you Israelites, you brothers and sisters, you can't hide yourself from God. You can't hide yourself from a secret place in a secret place where he can't see you. Why? Because we his people. He called us. He chose us. You made a covenant with him. Now it's time for you to come back to the covenant that was made with the Most High God. Read on.
Saith the Lord, do I feel heaven and earth? Saith the Lord.
And the Lord do feel heaven and earth. Now look, let's jump down to, go back to the video real quick and just hit play. So the Lord ain't sent these prophets because they ain't doing what the Most High want them to do. But you see people repenting and keeping the commandments of the household. You see the prophets. You see the priests. You see the protectors. You see the providers. You see the marriages. You see the changes. You see us standing up in the communities doing what God commanded us to do. You see the nation of Israel rising up on the planet Earth according to the prophecies. All right, play video.
A semblance of what it means to have the natural order that God had designed.
And this idea that God created us to be priest and prophet and provider and protector.
And so that little bit of kernel of truth that's found.
Kernel truth? This ain't kernel truth. This is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. What the hell are you talking about, bruh? This ain't no kernel truth. This is Bible.
That's what I was saying, Cap. He just trying to get, they want the men back
and
that, in church.
And that's why I had to touch this video. I had to touch it.
Hey, you know what it is, Cap? These men just don't have the testicular fortitude
right.
to get off their ass and go and do something that we're doing.
Right.
That's what it is.
And they're scared of Esau.
Yeah, absolutely.
They're scared of the white man.
Yeah.
You know, we go out here and teach this. I remember first hitting the streets. You remember we used to be on Beale Street all the time. Yeah. They used to be like, y'all ain't scared to be out here teaching this stuff?
Nope.
You know they gonna kill you, right? Yeah, they gonna kill us. Because yep. we love our people.
They're afraid
we
to lose.
We standing up for righteousness. We standing yep. up for our God.
Yep.
We trying to bring their kingdom down. If we keeping the commandments, that means you want their kingdom gone.
Exactly.
And you want God's kingdom on this earth.
They not willing to lose anything.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's the problem. They worry about their job. They worry about everything. Their family. Remember, what Christ say, if you're not, I might butcher it. What are you talking about? He say you want women to give up your life, you shall lose it. What's that scripture?
I think it's 10. And Matthew, whoever shall try to save his life shall lose it.
Yeah.
And whoever try to lose his life shall save it.
These brothers ain't trying to, they don't want to do nothing.
Yeah.
They don't want to do nothing.
Hey, you know what? I forgot where we was at, and brothers came to me, and they said, give me a good scripture, Cap, and that was the one I gave him. I said, bro, you can't save your life. Remember that. because we can't save our life. Even, look, once you come into this truth and you start to do this work and you start to deliver these blows to Christianity, because look, hey, we've been to finish Christianity off, trust me. Christianity been to be finished, completely finished off real soon. And guess, y'all know who we coming for next. We coming for all you Islam brothers. You so-called black Muslims. Y'all ain't no Muslims. Y'all, hey, look, all the division got to stop. We coming for y'all.
Right.
Just
hey,
wait.
Hey, Kev, you 100% right about that, because the video you showed, the woman feeding the dog, and the guy, and the people walking, they don't want to touch the black man, and you say they was Christians, either they gonna denounce the Bible, or they going to be like, they're going to have to switch it up.
Yeah.
So this is a heavy, heavy class.
Hey, all praise to the Most High. I hit y'all. You had some?
No, go ahead.
Okay. All right, hit play.
Organization is appealing to men because it appeals to the natural inclinations of men to be leaders, to be the ones that go out in the community and make change. And the church has made a lot of men passive. Why do you think? I'm gonna keep it real on this video, and you guys may not like everything I say, but it's all gonna be biblical and it's all gonna be based out of love. Most of the men you see in church leading stuff are either weak beta males or hyper feminine.
And now get that other video you just had. The weak beta males and the hyper feminine. First read Psalms chapter 50 verse 21. Because he said biblical order. When they see us, what they see? Biblical order. They see priests, protectors, providers. It was something else he said. And prophets. Priests, protectors, providers, and prophets. That's what they see when they see us, man, out there in unity. That's why I always tell y'all, brothers, when we blessing and we coming together like this, we making an impact. They ain't just looking at the one brother that got to teach out there or the couple brothers that got to teach out there. They looking at us as a unit. We one body in Christ. When they see all us out together, sitting up here, sacking this city. Because that's what we doing. We laying siege on these cities spiritually. And all of you got your angel with you. All of us got an angel with us. So not only is we laying siege on the cities, but all the men out there, your angel is right there with you, laying siege spiritually on this city. Y'all just don't understand the type of damage we doing, we coming in and out these places.
Hey, Cap, it is impossible to be an alpha male in Christianity. He's in Christianity. He's talking about a beta male. It is impossible
to be an alpha male
in Christianity.
Only the Bible can set that type of order in black Hispanic people. And that's what they don't understand. And they don't want to bring that type of truth. That's why it's so heavy. You know, they're not sincere when you read in Jeremiah 23.
Yeah.
They're not sincere in what they're teaching. They're not bringing the word for the healing of our people.
Yeah, they ain't trying to heal our people. They ain't trying to close the breaches.
Right.
Nope. You know what I'm saying? They ain't trying to patch up the holes in our communities. Psalms 50, verse 21.
Right, they want
to
keep it open so the money can keep flowing.
Yeah, keep the money flowing. Keep us in sin.
They ain't going on O-Block.
They ain't going on O-Block.
The book of Psalms, chapter 50, and verse 21. These things hast thou done, and I kept silent. Thou thoughtest that I was altogether such as one as thyself. But I will reprove thee and set them in order before thine eyes.
He said, I'm going to reprove them and set them in order. He said he's going to reprove you. And then he's going to set the Israelites in order before your eyes. That's what you see. Brother sitting out there marching. Captain's looking good. Now, I just want to let y'all captains know. Y'all was looking good out there. No homo. You got to say that because people be sitting up there, they'll take anything. Yeah, that brother said the captain was looking good. Hey, man, look, y'all was on point, man. Y'all was looking good marching and step at the Baltimore Blitz. What we call that, John? The Wild Wire Gets Wired Blitz. And it did get wired. And look, even though Esau tried to censor us, the news don't come out. You got videos that went viral, 5 and 6 million. 5 and 6 million views, 2, 3, 4 days. All praises to the Most High. They can't stop this truth. You can't stop this truth. The Lord said, I'm going to set them in order before thy eyes. That's what he see. He see the biblical order being set before his eyes. And guess what? We keep getting bigger, bigger, and bigger. And that wasn't even all of us. That was just a few of us. We can honestly say that now, then. I'm just a few of us. There wasn't even all of us. All right, now look, he said, in the church, it ain't number weak beta males and effeminate males in church. Now get that other video right there, this one. Look, y'all, this the proof of it.
y'all. Now I'm gonna stop. Stop
Johnny. Josephine.
I ain't trying to be funny. I ain't look.
Damn.
But I'm gonna ask a serious question right now.
Josephine, Johnny.
You know all that healing they be doing? You remember when the dude was just doing this?
Yeah.
Why nobody won't heal this woman?
They can't.
They can't.
She followed out. Yeah, whatever.
Just like when COVID came. They couldn't heal COVID. I'm just being honest. I ain't trying to mock this woman or nothing, but the Christian church claim they can do this stuff.
Right.
We sit up there, we go to James 5 and 14 and tell you how you gonna get your healing in this day and time.
Right.
You come to the elders of the church, we gonna anoint you with oil, and you confess your sins. And we'll fast and pray for you. Because sometimes you need somebody fasting and praying for you when you can't fast and pray for yourself. All right, hit play. Look at that feminine male in church. But check this out at the end, though. This the feminine male. I ain't never tried to cut a split in my life.
Hey, that's bitchy, ain't it? That's bitchy as Levi.
Oh, man.
Look at him.
This is how you know he almost lost the look. That dude, look, the dude went and jumped on the pole and started twerking. Oh, dang, I didn't even see this.
Josephine Johnny.
I didn't even see this. This the church.
Oh, man.
So this the church. Pastor, what script is this?
Nobody is rebuking this.
Nobody.
Nobody's rebuking this, but he don't rebuke us.
Nobody.
They say it's the Holy Ghost.
They say it's the Holy Ghost. That's they say.
But you know, the sister, and you probably can see why the Most High sitting up there and afflicted the sister. Imagine if she wasn't in that wheelchair.
Right.
If she at church and she decided to say, look, I'm going to pop my ass in front of everybody up in here. I'm going to get out of my wheelchair and I'm going to drop this damn thing like it's hot. Imagine what she'll be doing if she wasn't in the wheelchair.
Yeah.
And it's not to mock the woman or anything. You got to ask yourself, and a lot of times we feel sorry for people, but you got to ask yourself, what happened that the Most High put these people in these conditions? Oh, man, we're running out of time. Hold on, y'all. Hey, get the Joel Osteen real quick, y'all. Get the Joel Osteen. Now, look at this, because he said homosexualities, feminism, all of that stuff. Get that. And
many
I want you to get that
to get to the one God. Well, I believe, Oprah, that there, I believe that Jesus is the way to the one God. But I believe there are many paths to Jesus. And, you know, you don't know how Jesus would reveal himself to somebody. So I'm not into excluding people. Jesus can reveal himself to anybody.
Does that mean that all people, all races, obviously, in your church, we see all people, all races. I can't imagine that you would have 16,000 people in there and none of them would be gay. So are gay people also included?
Absolutely. Anybody is. You know.
This Oprah dude is a liar. That's why the Lord said, I have not sent them. Gays is not included. Get that real quick in 1 Corinthians chapter 6 and 9. Mm-hmm. And then I sent you a link I want you to put up after we read that. Put that Bible Hub link up, 1 Corinthians 6 and 9. These are damn Christian pastors. And they all, look, they what they call it, the one council of churches, the world council of churches, they all teach the same thing. Yeah, everybody is included. Let's see what Christ said. Let's see what Paul said in the spirit of Christ. Read.
1 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 9. Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God?
The unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Read.
Be not deceived, neither fornicators.
The fornicators ain't included to get the kingdom of God. Read on.
Nor idolaters.
The idolaters ain't included. Because people be talking about, why y'all so talking about Christmas all the time? Because it's idolatry. Why are you talking about birthdays all the time? Because it's idolatry. Why are you talking about Easter? Because it's idolatry. Why are you talking about Valentine's Day? Because it's idolatry. Read on.
Nor adulterers.
No adulterers ain't going to get the kingdom of God. They ain't included. Read.
Nor effeminate.
Nor the effeminate. Nor that dude that grabbed the pole and got the shaking. He ain't included. Read on.
Nor abusers of themselves with mankind.
Nor abusers with themselves of mankind. Now let's see what abuser of themselves of mankind is. Give me that Bible hood real quick. Let's get that Bible hood. They ain't included. What the hell is Joel Osteen talking about?
Absolutely.
That's why I said the death for Christian is over with for Christianity. That's why they said, you know what? We got to get rid of them. We got to get that group right there. Right there. That's the purple and gold. All right. Read the New International Version. Right there. So this 1 Corinthians 6 and 9. These different versions so we can know who the abusers of themselves with mankind is. You got it?
1 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 9. New International Version.
You're going to have to read into the mic. Can't nobody hear you.
Yeah. You want me to read it? Can you see it good?
I can see it.
Okay.
New International Version. Or do you not know that wrongdoers will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived. Neither the sexually immoral, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor men who have sex with men.
Or men who have sex with men. Now, the New Living Translation, or practice homosexuality. English Standard Version, nor men who practice homosexuality. The Berean Standard Bible, nor men who submit to perform homosexual acts. The Berean Literal Bible, no homosexuals. What the hell is Joel Osteen talking about? But you know why the reason why these churches don't teach against homosexuality? Hey, I'm running out of time, man. It's something called quid pro quo. Now get that real quick. Pull that definition up. Quid pro quo. This is why the reason why people leave in the church. This dude talking about, we got carnal truth. What the hell you mean? We got the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. All right, let me say we speaking the truth. All right, get that real quick. Wikipedia, quid pro quo. The meaning of quid pro quo. Here you go.
Quid pro quo. Quid pro quo, Latin. Something for something is a Latin phrase used in English to mean an exchange of goods or services in which one transfer in contingent upon another. A favor for a favor.
Hey, look, we gonna support your church. We gonna support your political party, but you gotta stand for these gay rights. Yep. You gotta stand for same-sex marriages. That's what quid pro quo is. That's why these pastors ain't, that's why everybody's included. They getting money, they getting paid.
We're going to pass certain grants and certain things for your church. Just make sure you teach about homosexuality.
Yeah,
in your
just
church.
Tell them they include it. Just say they include it, and they're going to give you $1 million a year. Right. Just say they include it, they're going to give you this. Just say they include it. Just say this, just say that. It's called quid pro quo. That's why. Why you think it's so many gay rights and all of this stuff being passed? Because they sat up there, they got the power, right? The homosexuals, they got the power to sit up there and put money behind this. The LGBT ain't just no little thing. You got billionaires that's homosexuals and stuff that want these rights and laws passed. So they put money behind politics and all that to get these laws passed. Why do you think we can't ever get a bill?
Right.
Black people don't got no money to put behind nothing. We broke.
Yeah, you have all these black pastors that are meet with the president every year, have these secret meetings with the presidents. What you think they're talking about?
Right. Now, look, man, I'm going to have to wrap it. Man, I got so much. I'm just going to jump down, man. Okay, the truth is flourishing. So, finish this video up. Oh, yeah, get the other video. Now, finish this video up first. I'm going to finish this up so I can go and get knock the rest of it out. All the feminine males in church, Joel Osteen lying. The church is just a lie. It's simple as that, man.
Go back to the other video.
Acts 17.
Take that off the screen. Go back to the other video.
Yep. So read why they getting that. Read that Jeremiah 23 and 21. Because even when he said, Joel Osteen said that everybody is included. What scripture is that? What scripture is that with homosexual included when we just read the scripture said they ain't included? They got to repent of their homosexuality. And that's one thing you don't hear these churches talking about. They ain't talking about repentance. Read.
Jeremiah chapter 23 and verse 21. I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran.
The Lord didn't send John Osteen, but he did what? He ran in no. He prophesied no. He sent up there speaking the word of God. God didn't send John Osteen. Read.
I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesy.
He said he ain't spoken to them, but yet they prophesy. Yet they got God's word in their mouth. And they butchering the scriptures. They lying on our God. Where we at? You got the video ready for me yet? Pastor Joe Osteen, what scripture is this? For real. Where we at?
Hey, I say we. Maybe the Christian community makes a bigger deal out of gay, out of being gay, but...
Will a gay person be accepted into heaven as you see it?
Well, I believe they will.
Wow!
I believe
it. He say, no, ye not. No, ye not that the unrighteous be not deceived. This is a deceiver. And this is why we call the white man the devil. Everybody be like, oh, yeah, they just some racist. They just hate white people. No, the white man is a devil. He's a deceiver. The Bible says, know ye not, be not deceived. If you're a female or a homosexual, you will not get the kingdom of God. You got to repent of that. You got to repent of your adultery. You can't be effeminate and get the kingdom of God. Don't y'all understand that Christ's kingdom, the kingdom that's coming on earth is Israelite rulership with Christ as the head, as the king? We don't want feminists in our kingdom. Right. See, this they understand that this is our kingdom.
Right.
We're saying we don't want you effeminate men there. The brother next to me masculine. All these men around me masculine. The men that's marching masculine. And when we find out that they got any effeminate in them, guess what we're going to do? We're going to rebuke it out of them. Right. If they want to stay effeminate, they got to go. If we find out they practicing homosexuality, they got to go. They can't be with us. Because
right.
It said, be not deceived. The unrighteous ain't going to get the kingdom of God. All right, where we at, y'all? I got 10 minutes. So, woo!
Need a part two.
Hey, don't mention all the brother video. All right, y'all, I'm going to wrap it up, man. It is what it is.
Deuteronomy chapter 23 and 17 said, there should be no whore of the daughters of Israel, nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel.
Hey, Cap, you can tell, he know he has power. The white man has power in this earth because he said, I said. Because Oprah asked him, do you believe that gays going to get in there? He said, "That's what." Yeah, I believe that. He didn't say what the Bible said. He said, I believe that. Yeah, they're going to be in there. That's how much power in his head, the proudness in him.
That's why they stole away from the Bible.
And people believe what he say, not what the Bible say.
Right. I go back to the first video that we put up. Let's finish his video out, and then I'm going to close it out. So look, y'all, this wasn't an attack on the brother, but this is the death of Christianity. It's over with, y'all. It is what it is, y'all. Christianity can't stand no more. This brother even said it. He said it. It played.
I wish you would show them chitlins.
Start jumping around with tight pants and are gay. The black church is no longer relevant.
Bam! The black church is no longer relevant. It's over for the black church.
That's right.
The death of Christianity is here. The men leaving it. I left that church. Not only is they leaving the church, I left that gang. I left that hood. I left those streets. Yep. The men leaving all of that. Why? Because the true prophets are on earth teaching the true word of God.
That's right.
This ain't no kernel truth. Yeah, they got a little kernel truth up in there. No, this is the truth.
That's it.
All right, here, play.
An outlet. And so they're turning to organizations like Israel United in Christ. So what does that mean? So what, as a biblical conservative, what does that mean to me? That means that the message of the Bible, the true message of the gospel, needs to be preached in a way that men can receive it. The church, every church, has adulterated the word, twisted the word for financial gain or to gain clout and political power, and the real gospel has not been preached in a long, 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 long time. Combination of prosperity, feminism, homosexuality, and a bunch of other things have crept into the church and have caused a lot of pastors not touch on topics where they should touch on. There's a strong Jezebel spirit within the black church. And a lot of these pastors are stroking that ego of that Jezebel spirit because they like the windfall that comes from it. And so it's time to speak out about this stuff and call it what it is. That the church needs to be reformed. The church needs a resuscitation. The church needs to be the church. Because otherwise, men are not going to join it. And if men are not joining your church, the Lord wants his men back. And if men are not going to join the church will crumble because the men are the covering of the church, just like the men are the covering of the home. So while other people may bash the Israel United in Christ organization because of some of the things they say they're not a hate group. I haven't seen them say anything that would be considered hateful to me. I know Kyrie Irving got into trouble by talking about this stuff, but the main point I want to make is men are looking for an organization that appeals to the natural inclinations of the men, especially black men who have always gotten the short end of the stick and felt downtrodden. And that's why a lot of black men are joining this organization, because the church no longer welcomes them. The church wants them to be perpetual victims. And I'm here to tell you, brothers, you're not victims. You are empowered for greatness. The word of God will elevate you to the point to where you will be who God has created you to be. You will reign as kings in this life, brothers, but you have to study the real gospel, the real word of God, and live it.
And see, and that's why I say all of the extra stuff behind it. See, that's what they call bittersweet right there, or nasty nice. But y'all got to study the real word of God. You're going to be king. Right. Look, man, look, we here. We here and dying. You see where the men at. You see where the men flocking to. You see where the women coming to. You see the folks leaving the church. Bro, it's over with for Christianity. Like you said, it needs to be resuscitated. It ain't going to be resuscitated long as the priests, the prophets, the protectors, and the providers walking this earth. Bits in these cities, teaching every day and keeping the commandments of God. So look, y'all, I got 5 minutes. I guess I'm gonna leave it alone. There's some other stuff I want to bring out. I'm gonna stop.
Can I say something? He kind of wrong on that. He said men are leaving just to join because the men, right? Because they see the men. No, we join Israel United in Christ because the bishops, the leaders, is teaching the word of God.
The commandments of God.
That's what's bringing these men into the organization. The Bible is what teaches us how to be a man according to the Lord. That's what's happening. So you're talking about it ain't the Bible.
Yeah.
You know, he teaching the word, or we ain't teaching it right. This is proof that the Bible is being taught in its proper form.
Right.
That's why you see blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans at all different age groups, from 20 to 80, standing up for the word of God in one in unity. Come on, bro.
Hey, because the Christian church ain't got the answers.
They don't got
all the answers. They doing is pop locking and popping ass.
They got the answers,
and on the pole. That's why they leaving the Christian church, because they ain't got the understanding. The black men, true black men, are seeing where the understanding is, and that's why they come in, because the Spirit of God is moving on the earth.
That's
and you
why
see
they
where the understanding is coming.
And you know, we did that I joined IUIC challenge a couple of years ago. Everybody said that. They heard the teachers. They didn't see groups of men. They heard the teachers.
Right.
And they said, hold on, this is the truth. Just like with me, I heard 1 John 5:3. It said, if you love God, keep the commandments. Mm-hmm. I had to make a choice. Because I said I love the Lord. Guess what I did? I started keeping the commandments.
Can I get a scripture real quick? Get John 8:32. This is what happening to us. John 8:32. This is why a lot of us.
Don't play the video right.
I don't think we have enough time for it. You got enough time for it? All right, we're going to play the video. Drop the scripture. We're going to play the video.
Scripture, bro. Get the scripture.
All right, read that.
The book of John, chapter 8:32.
Read.
And ye shall know the truth.
You should know what?
The truth.
Ye should know the truth. We are the children of Israel. We are great. When I heard that I'm the child, Deuteronomy 28 talking about me. I'm Israel. God loves me. I'm above all nations. I'm great. Read that again.
And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
That's gonna make my marriage better. That's gonna make me be a better brother, husband, father. The truth. The truth is God's commandments. All right, you can play this video.
Churches have been a cornerstone for African Americans. From slavery to the civil rights movement and community building, the church is seen as a foundation in many communities. A Washington Post poll found that black women are the most religious in the country. But now many black women are leaving the pews in droves and giving up their religious affiliation. Here with me now on what's being called the Great Exodus from the Church is educator Candace Marie Benbow. She's the author of the new book, The Red Lip Theology. Good to have you with us. Listen, on any given Sunday, you know, you can walk into a black church and you see a lot of black women. But you talk about in your book that black women, voices, and experiences are not at the forefront of any faith dialogue in the black church, despite being statistically more religious. Tell us your thoughts about the state of black women in the church.
Thanks for having me. The larger issue here is the fact that for black women to be the most religious demographic in America and not have the prominent voice in leadership in their churches, as well as the voice in spiritual formation in the nation, speaks very much to the racism and the gendered oppression that black women are experiencing. And I think that what we're seeing in this moment of an exodus, even within a pandemic, is black women finding ways to, one, honor their spiritual formation and their faith development, while also giving voice to the need for black women to be respected in all spheres.
But this man gave me a feminist video.
Get the Jezebel off the screen.
Get the Jezebel out of here, man. Get the Jezebel out of here, man. But no, but so this video said they leaving the church to go do their own thing. Right. But a lot of them leaving the church to go into witchcraft. Right. Now, and that's the truth. A lot of them leaving the church to go into witchcraft and do some other fine divine thing that they want to do. But what you had a point you wanted to make out of that, though?
No. It was going with your other videos. No,
okay. Yeah. No, that's all good. It's all good. But no, and that's what it says. See, the church supports feminism. I don't know what the hell she talking about. The women got leadership role, 27%. Matter of fact, I had another video with Esau on it, because I'm going to tell you that's a lie real quick. That's some BS. Get the video I sent you. It's with Esau, and then I'm going to wrap it up after that, y'all. I have to follow back with that one. It said Christian church support feminism. The Christian church supports feminism. I sent it to you, y'all. It's an Instagram video. The Christian church supports feminism. A lot of people leaving the church because they know it's lies up in the church.
It's confusing. That church is confusing. The other guy just said you played, he said that, well, there's no roles for the men in the church.
Yeah.
Then she come and says no roles for the women. The church is confusing as hell.
It's all lies. That's what I'm saying. It's deceit. She just trying to sell a book. That's all. That's why I say theology is all
her stuff. Red lip
then
theology.
You see her with a book, her Jezebel red lipstick with her lips all out, and that long white woman weave up in her head. Simple as that. She hates herself.
Like that woman
the first
the
thing I see when I see a woman with that long ass weave in her, then her that ain't her, I see self-hatred. When I don't see natural hair. I'm just telling you, look, sisters, it is when I don't see natural hair, the first thing I see is self-hatred. You got that for me, Daniela? Oh, not this one. That's the wrong one. Oh, man. It's the one that said, can women preach a pastor? Something like that. That one. Can women preach a pastor? My fault. See, I had a slew of it. Y'all, look, I had about 100 videos.
So you got to do that part two, Cap.
Part two?
You got to do that part two.
Yes, sir. We'll do a part two. Lord willing.
And that part two going to go into the feminism.
Yeah. Because that's what it was going to lead into. Feminism. Yep. Okay. All right, do we got it? So get that real quick in Jeremiah 23 and 21. I'm going to keep reading it. I'm going to keep
got
reading it. Then, all right, here you go.
Oh, yeah.
Now look at this. Look how she going directly, she been directly defy the church.
1 Corinthians 14:34. Apostle Paul says, let your women keep silent in the churches, for they are not permitted to speak, but they are to be submissive, as the law also says. Why did he preach that? When you look at scripture, you need to look at the time period, and you need need to look at the context, what was going on at that church of Corinth. The women in the church were being loud and distracting during church. That's just what they were doing at that time. Because they were being that way, this obviously was making it so God's word was not being able to go forth because there was so much distraction. It was messing with the work of God. So because of what was going on, Apostle Paul used wisdom for this moment in time and spoke a prophetic direction. Okay, women, you guys need to keep silent in the churches. Ask your husbands at home. Apostle Paul was not saying that for all women. He was just speaking that for these women at that time because of what they were doing. First Corinthians 4.
You know why this is a lie? Because he said, as in all the churches of the saints.
So said the law.
And that's why I said the Christian church, they support feminism.
She said, she was like, he ain't talking to me. That's basically
what she said. No, he ain't talking to me. No, I was just talking about them for that time. But the Christian church teaches that. She heard that from a pastor. Yep. Pastor, what scripture is that? It was just for that time. Because he said, as in all the all the churches of the saints. But look, y'all, we're going to go and wrap it up. It's 10 o'clock. Hey, look, I pray and hope y'all was edified with that. Say shalom, most high, Christ bless.
Shalom, most high. Yeah, I'm going to find you, hold me down, I never